morning to all of you. And again, it's really great to be back on a Saturday. And as I can see, the number of participants now is 21. So I would like to start with the number 21. That is 21st September is celebrated as World Alzheimer's Awareness Day. And September as a month is also celebrated as Alzheimer's Awareness Month. Of course, that doesn't mean that we only celebrate it and remember them or remember those who can. Remember those who forget only on this month or these days. No. What we have to do is we have to take care of them throughout. So, but what I am today going to elaborate about is how to preserve or how to keep your brain healthy and try to preserve your memory. So there are, of course, certain tips. As we age, of course, we know that there is going to be age-related changes as far as your brain is concerned. But you can obviously boost the memory. So the things which you need to take care of include, the first one is always give your brain a challenge. Your brain needs a workout. A brain-boosting activity helps. And how it should be. It should be something that teaches you something new. It should be challenging. It's a skill you can build on. And it should be rewarding. So something like playing a guitar, playing chess, speaking a new language, or trying to learn a new skill. All these things are important so that they improve your memory. But at the same time, the brain gets bored. So the brain has to be challenged and engaged. So it has to be a new skill. Secondly, never ever skip your physical exercise. Because physical exercise is very important. The oxygen amount, it increases oxygen to your brain, reduces the risk for other disorders like your cardiovascular disease and your diabetes. So it will always help enhancing all the chemicals in the brain and reducing your stress hormones. So brain boosting exercise tips will obviously include aerobic exercise. It's good for brain. So mostly most exercises which are good for your heart will be good for your brain. Then sometimes when you get up, you feel quite tired in the morning. So what we need to do is sometimes you need to do exercising first thing in the morning because it helps in clearing out your cobwebs and it also primes you for learning throughout the day. So physical activities which need hand-eye coordination and complex motor skills are very good for brain building. Then exercise breaks can actually help you in overcome mental fatigue. For example, you're doing something, but you feel fatigued. So maybe a short walk can obviously help in rerouting your brain. Then very important. Sleep. Now, sleep is so important. We need to be actually sort of making sure we sleep well. So why was that always said? Because sleep helps in consolidating our memories. It actually helps in consolidating whatever we have read, whatever we have learned. So how do we do that? Sleep well, get on a sleep schedule, avoid all the screens. I mean, before bed, if you have any blue light, whether it's TVs, tablets, phones, it's never good. And try to cut back on your caffeine amount of tea, coffee, especially even the morning coffee can interfere. So be very specific on the amount you take. Fourth is have plenty of time for your friends, for your relationships, because healthy relationships are the ultimate brain booster. And you can do anything. For example, all of you can do online clubs now, volunteer when things get way. Then value of a pet has also been seen very important for the mental makeup. Tip five is please keep stress in check. How do you manage stress? Have realistic expectations for what you want to do during the day. Take breaks. Express your feelings rather than just bottling it up in your mind. Have a healthy balance between your work and your leisure time. And always try to focus on one task at a time rather than thinking I have to do this, I have to do that. So stress has to be kept at bay. And it's very rightly said because you have always heard that laughter is the best medicine. So laughter actually is very, very good. It helps in boosting your brains, which are vital for learning and creativity. So one is, of course, you can laugh at yourself. Whatever your embarrassing moments are, take it in a good light. When you hear laughter, move towards it. So when you actually have an opportunity to laugh, it only helps. Humor usually rubs off from one person to another. Spend time with fun, playful people so that you actually get a chance to laugh more. And surround yourself with reminders to lighten up. Or it could be anything. It could be a screensaver. It could be a small joke. It could be a photos when you're having fun. And of course, grandchildren, children, when they are playing, they take life so differently and lightly. Seeing their innocence, seeing that this itself will give you a nice laugh and smile. Then diet is very important. Eat a brain boosting diet. Get your omega-3 fatty acids, which are said. Fish is very good in omega-3 fatty acids. If you don't like seafood, things like spinach, broccoli, pumpkin seeds, soya beans are good. Limit your calories and saturated fats, especially red meat, whole meat, butter, cheese. Eat more fruits and vegetables because they have plenty of antioxidants. Then a lot of research now is saying that green tea is actually good. It helps in enhancing memory and mental alertness and also slowing your brain aging. Then identify and treat your health problems. Please don't forget your health problems. Heart disease and risk factors like cholesterol, high blood pressure have to be taken care of. Diabetes has to be taken care of. Hormonal imbalance, especially thyroidism, hypothyroidism should be taken into consideration. Forgetfulness and confusion can be there in hypothyroidism. Always, if you feel you're low, emotional difficulties can be difficult on the brain. So is it depression? So we need to get the doubt of depression out before you think that is actually a memory problem, because the memory will return to normal. So make sure that if you feel depressed, it should be treated. Then practical tips that you should do for support your learning and memory include: always pay attention. You can't remember everything that you have learned. So try to encode. If you pay attention, then only you'll be able to sort of get that piece of information. Try to write down the piece of information, the to-do list, if you're not able to remember. Involve as many as senses. They say if you open up, involve senses, it will be nice. For example, colors, remember colors, textures, smells, tastes. So that is obviously involving different parts of the brain, and ultimately it will help to make an imprint. Relate information to what you already know and then add new information. If it is a complex material, then try to focus on the basic things. And rehearse information if you have already learned. For example, try to write it down. Try to write things you forget. Try to keep things that are essential always in a place which is accessible to you. Whether it's a box, whether it's your keys, whether it's your very highly essential use, your drugs, all should be organized so that you can get access to it. Remember, to remember, you need to just make an effort so that you can actually exercise the brain in a good way. And that's how we should go about it. So in general, this was, of course, overall how to sort of helping you in tips to helping you in actually improving your memory. So thanks a lot for your patient hearing. If you have any other questions, you can sort of get them through.
Thank you very much, doctor. In case anybody has a question, please unmute yourself. Ask your question and again mute yourself so that we don't disturb anybody else. Any questions?
Yes, I have one question, doctor.
Yeah.
Am I audible?
Yes.
A close relative of mine, living with me, has a difficulty of focusing on whatever she does. She is 84 years old. Otherwise, she is okay health-wise, etc. No particular disease or anything. How can we help her to focus?
Ma'am,
the time she is over with it.
Ma'am, without knowing her exact history and all those things, it will be very difficult for me to give you general tips. So it would be best that I actually get to know more about her, because what applies for somebody will not apply for everybody. So it will not be easy for me to just generalize it.
Any other questions from?
Yeah, can I ask a question, please?
Yes.
Okay, so I'm Tinky Bharadwaj. My mother-in-law is 93 years old. And okay. We've noticed since the last, say, 8-9 months, she's forgetful. And recently she's moved after a lot of persuasion to stay with us. Okay. There are some days when she's totally disoriented. She doesn't know who we are. Other days she seems to be fine. And when she has played, Rummy all her life. When we play Rummy with her, she remembers her card, sequence, everything. But she'll get up and say, now I want to go to my room. Which side should I go? Should I go straight or should I go left or right or whatever? We had consulted a neurologist about 6 weeks ago. And he said, yes, she couldn't remember her children's name. She couldn't remember our names, her grandchildren, her great-grandson. She couldn't remember. And he did say she has first stage dementia. Okay. Some she hallucinates. So he had given her medicine and it became worse. She thought she's living in a resort and she said there are so many people here. There are ladies in my room. So, it was, but for her, that entire episode was so real. We didn't argue with her. We only listened to her, but we completely stopped the medication and she became okay. But disorientation continues. Some days she's lucid and some days completely in some other world.
Okay. So again, ma'am, in her case, because you're asking me a specific question, of course, you have given me a general idea. But then I would need more details. One is, of course, 93-year-old, I can agree. So there is a bit of age-related memory loss will be there. But apart from that, the fact that she is obviously getting often disoriented. There are a lot of causes of disorientation which might have to be sort of ruled out in her. So I think,
we did that test that the doctor told us. All that was her report is so normal, you cannot imagine.
Okay.
She only takes a BP tablet since the last 3-4 years, very small dose. And her sugar was fasting was 113. Otherwise,
Ma'am, again, I might have to see. I will need more details purely because it's very difficult for me and this platform to actually address specific complaint. Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Any other questions for the doctor? Doctor, as a vegetarian, what can we do to ensure that omega-3 comes into our body to help our memory?
Yeah, so as a vegetarian, of course, you can take things like broccoli. You can take things like spinach, walnuts. These are all kidney beans. These are all actually, and soya beans also. These are all actually non-fish sources of omega-3 fatty acids. As I said, of course, fish is particularly rich, but spinach, kidney beans, walnuts, pumpkin seeds, broccoli, spinach, these are good, and soya beans. So these are all which can be actually added.
Thank you. Any other questions for the doctor?
Yes, can I ask a question?
Something, yeah.
Can I ask?
Sure.
My mother-in-law is 102 years old. She's very mobile. She can go to the toilet and everything on her own. But continuous repetition. She'll ask one thing and she'll repeat the same thing again and again. So it tries our patience. And then otherwise she's all the time worried about what the maid will eat. And otherwise she's fine mentally. She can play cards very well.
Okay.
But she doesn't. We have stopped newspapers because of the COVID. Yeah. Otherwise, she used to read the newspaper. So, how to pass her time? We try and occupy, but she seems to be losing interest. But this repetition is quite, annoying. But then the same thing goes on in the 5 minutes, she'll ask the same thing 10 times.
Okay, first of all, she's 102. Great. First of all, she's 102, so that itself is absolutely great. She's done something right to cross 100. And she's one of the few who's actually seen both the pandemics. I'm sure. Right. I mean, when she was born, the first pandemic actually happened. So the thing is, I would say if repetition is there, it's okay to be very frank. At 102, I wouldn't want to treat a lot of things in her. If she is actually independent in her activities of daily living, like bathing, eating, if she's doing all that independently, then and she's actually not dependent on you for anything. Maybe if many minor things, then I should not be worried. Repetition can be a part of course, memory loss. But again, at 102, we are expecting the brain to have shrunk to a great extent. Yes. And a bit of memory loss is there. I think the problem, of course, is the newspapers is gone. So is she tech savvy? By tech savvy, I don't mean being online everything. If you provide her newspapers on the, I mean, maybe the computer or an iPad, will she read?
No, I tried that. She has, okay. She loses interest. But if I put on a Hitchcock movie or Sherlock Holmes, she will enjoy that. That so, she does, and she put on dramas. She can go to the bathroom on her own. She can't. We don't let her bathe on her own. But
okay,
she can
that's fine.
Eat on her own.
Okay.
But the continuous this thing, I want to go to the toilet every few minutes, and then I have to be very firm and say, "No, you're not going." Then if she's playing cards, she can sit for 2 hours. Otherwise,
okay.
You know, lack of occupation, she just wants to go run. Kuch kaam
nahi hota hai. So I would say we would want to introduce maybe certain more activities. Maybe you should try and do that, because if the time has to be, she has to be kept occupied. She seems to,
yes.
And if you see whatever her interests are, then you need to sort of modify, of course, according to that, because you see quite a bit of interests are there, and I'm sure she would sort of pull through that. Newspaper reading was something which was very significant for most older adults, but unfortunately that has been cut off. So if she is interested in seeing, I mean, the news as far as, unfortunately, even the news channels go totally crazy these days. So she has to be shown certain news which is actually valid. So that is one way, because even audio news are there online in which there is no video. So you can only get snippets. So that is also some way you should sort of. So I would say if you see her, I think you should just keep her busy. Because at 102, fine, evaluating is okay. But our question is how much more you want to do for her? Because she is, if not entirely independent, she is not totally dependent also. She's quite independent. Yeah.
Okay.
So try to keep her active. I mean, try to keep her occupied. I think that would be the most important thing to do.
Yes. Okay.
We'll take one last question as the doctor has to leave.
Why are you making me? I'm putting my hand quite often.
Hello. Yes, Rui. Can you now ask your question?
Yeah, doctor. I am a senior citizen, and I tend to forget. Now, what I do is, what I forget, I write down in a notebook and refer to it as often as I can, so that I don't forget when I talk. Is that a good idea?
Absolutely. You are trying to, because you are trying to retrain yourself. So it's a very good idea, because you are making sure that if you forget, at least you have a second thing that, no, you can look it up. So what's happening is we tend to remember a lot of things even when we are younger. But
correct.
When we write it down, we are actually consolidating it to a certain extent to actually put even one more way of remembering. So I think it's a very good idea. You should write it down. And you should look it up so that you remember, okay, fine, this is something I have to do. This is something I have to do. So, yeah, you should do it. That's a good idea.
Thank you, doctor.
Yeah.
Doctor, I think we have time for one more question. I think then we'll have to end it.
Yeah, yeah.
Doctor, yes. Dr. Prem, can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm Hannah.
Yeah, ma'am. Tell me.
Doctor, I'm recently realizing that I do something like I take the... open the water bottle, I pour it out in the glass, I keep the water back, but in the lid of that bottle, I keep it on the glass, and the glass lid, I keep it on the bottle. This kind of wrong things I'm doing of late, you know. Then,
but then you're realizing it also.
Yes, I'm realizing. Uh-huh. And then I'm very fond of reading. Then I read and I do a lot of Bible study.
Yeah.
It very detailed and very deep, and I try to write down lot. Because every time I can't carry the Bible, heavy Bible with me. So I try to write on the scribbling pads, lot of things. But what I do upstairs in my room is on the first floor. What I do upstairs, by that time everything is so nice. I understand, I write it down, but by that time I go down, nothing I remember. Nothing, okay. Absolutely nothing I remember. Again, I had to come back and check what I have written. So at least 7-10 times at least I keep reading the same thing. Then okay. When I'm lying down, I try to remember what I read, the thing. It takes time, but it's a lot of efforts I had to put in that.
Yeah.
Then.
Yeah. So I would say you have drafted, of course, a strategy on how to sort of remember, because you are trying to do it. I can understand that it takes time, but then you are acting because you obviously have got older. So yeah. a bit of retraining has to be done. So I think you're doing it well. So don't get, because you're still trying to remember. If you really have a lot of memory problems, then you will not be able to do that as well. So the fact that you're still trying to devise strategies to remember is great. So I think you should continue doing that. The time frame that might be taking is because as we get older, when we learn things, when we try to remember things, it might just take a bit longer as compared to normal, but that is okay. Because you have to give yourself that particular time, because ultimately you have sort of done it throughout your life. So it's not that you're only doing it now. So now a bit more effort will be there, and it's good that you're taking it. I would say it's really nice that you're actually taking so much effort, and it's very good.
Yeah. Even when I go for a bath, very often I open the tap, but I forget to put the geyser button on. Then when I say, oh, water is so cold, what happened? Then I realize I have not put the geyser on. So this kind of small, a lot of these minor things I'm doing nowadays.
Yeah, but and then I still feel that you're trying to devise strategies to overcome it. So that is good. And you're realizing it. If you didn't realize it, then it might be an issue. But you're realizing it. So that is good.
Yeah, I realize that.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, doctor. I know you have to go. You have a patient waiting. Everybody, again, on behalf of all of us here, thank you very much, doctor, for doing this week on week. In case anybody would like to talk to the doctor for a private consultation, write to us at Tare Social and we will connect you to him. You can also visit our website and his contact details are there on our website. You can connect there. Thank you very much, doctor, and see you again next week.
Thank you, doctor. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Bye.